Let me go ahead and close out some personal tabs real quick so we can take a look at it. I see it's the Porsche website. And describe your last car purchase aloud. It was a Toyota Corolla. So this is something that was purchased a few years ago. It was through, you know, an online source, like a dealer or third party. It was not that bad, ultimately, because I was able to find some of the features and functions I was able wanted through not only this site, but on third-party review sites as well. Okay, I have completed the task. How often do you go to sites like this? Well, we have Porsche, which is a vehicle manufacturer site. So if you're referring specifically to any vehicle manufacturer site, yeah, I definitely visit once in a while. Luxury, you know, I would say rarely. So I'll kind of blend that out and say sometimes, right? It is definitely an occasional visit as opposed to like an everyday kind of affair. So imagine you always wanted to own a Porsche since you were a little kid. Yep. I mean, of course, right? Who doesn't? But yep, we need to be able to afford it as well. So we received a substantial bonus and you have about $100,000 saved to make your childhood dream come true. We're in the burbs with your spouse, two kids, and your work is about 40 minutes away. Go ahead and try to find a car that meets the needs. Excellent. So yeah, let's go ahead and like try to find a car, you know, that meets your needs. So I'm going to try to build out a Porsche, right? I think it makes sense if you try to, you know, discover perhaps. No, that's not going to work. I was trying to look for like a little quiz, right, based on like your seating capacity and your specific needs. So why don't we go ahead and compare models, all right? So I am in North America, United States. So here we go. And yeah, now I'm going to go ahead and search. Oh, it takes me right to the same site. All right. So let's go ahead and then maybe go in locally, okay? It might make more sense to go in locally and then try and find something specific. So, oh, wait, but I'm supposed to stay on this site. Okay. So I'm already a little bit confused, right? Because I'm trying to find something that meets all those criteria. So if we have two kids, wife and yourself, definitely probably need, you know, like the SUV. All right. And let's look at the Cayenne models. Okay. And work is 40 miles each way, I believe. And we need to find something $100,000 or less. So let's go ahead and kind of take a look, okay? This is gas-powered, I believe. This is not electric. Oh, no, it's an e-hybrid. Interesting. Okay. So I'm kind of going through, right? Let me look at the interior, right? I have to see what kind of seating capacity there is. Oh, wait, nope, but that's more like the engine. Okay. So, hey, let's kind of flip it back here. All right, so we have the Cayenne concept, right? Build and price. Here we go. Okay, this should help me considerably, right? So I'm going to kind of scroll down here a bit. Technical specs. There we are. Okay, so let's see what the seating capacity looks like. Oh, it is really hard to find the seating capacity for some reason, right? Interior. So performance would that wouldn't be a fuel consumption. Okay, here we go. You get about 23 miles per gallon highway. What is the fuel tank capacity? 23 gallons. That's great for your 40-minute trip. So that would work. Also, we need to be able to try to find something with seating. There we go. 8-way comfort seats in the front. 4+1, 5. That works out great for you, your spouse, your teenage kids. Okay. And, you know, this is $70,000. So it's one of the cheaper models. So that's a pretty good deal. And yeah, let me go ahead and add this to the cart. Let's try to build it out a little bit, right? Because I think it is particularly helpful if I can build. One thing I'm finding really frustrating about the site is it is so hard just to go in to the pricing. Here we go. Okay. So this is a $76,000 model. I think you can see my screen. Okay. So we'll leave the standard color. All right. Beige. All right, we'll leave the wheels as is. I'm more concerned about like the performance here, okay? Interior color is fine, black or gray, right? Actually, gray is better, otherwise you'll roast in the summer. So let's go gray, okay? All right, I'm just trying to build this out a little bit. Oh, wow, there are way too many options here, right? You know what, the zone climate control is good, especially if you have kids, so everybody can, you know, get their heating and cooling as applicable. All right. And all right. It looks like I built it out. $77,790. So it is within my price point. And there we go. Honestly, it was like a neutral. Okay. One of the things I'm looking for is like a quiz. I always try to find like a quick quiz that at least helps me understand, right, what's the best model for me. And over here, that function was definitely lacking. It is a very great site to explore, but it isn't a great site if you just want to get, you know, some quick technical specs. Hey, I found my dream car and it's within my budget. You will be installing the EV chargers. Free for everybody to use, it'll save me $3,000. Now I have to look at an EV version. Okay. All right. So let's go in. We're going to go back to the homepage. And now I need to, yeah, look into the EV, right? As opposed to gas powered. I'm going to flip it a little bit further down. Let me see where the EVs are. I'm not too familiar with which model is electrified. So we're going to have to kind of come back here. We'll go to shop. New and used inventory. Okay. And I think this is the EV right over here. Panorama, right? Fairly certain this is the EV. Okay. Well, let's go into new. Hold on. Oh, nope. It is not available in EV. All right. We'll flip it back. Let's go back in here to the main Porsche website. And let's go ahead and see which one is available as an electrified vehicle. So, oh, here we go. Taycan GTS. Okay, that's fine. Here we are. Oh, but that's $134,000. So that's not going to work. So let's see if there's any cheaper options. Again, right, you need to try to keep it. There we go. The Taycan 4 Cross Turismo. Okay, so that's actually pretty helpful. All right. And so let's go ahead and take a look versus what we initially went through. We'll look at the technical specs. So we have to look at the range. 235 miles, so 80 miles a day. That means you're going to have to charge it a few times a week, 10 and a half hours of charge. Let me see what your boss said here. Okay, they don't necessarily indicate what kind of charging capacity there is. And we need to try to find the seating. And it is 2 plus 2, 4 is enough. That's sufficient. Let's go ahead and try to build this out real quick. All right, we're basically at budget, so I can't really upgrade anything. Okay, let me go ahead and flip it through. So it's about $20,000 more expensive if I'm heading all the way to the bottom, okay, versus the older car. So I'd probably choose the gas-powered one just because at this point, I'd rather, you know, keep under budget. It was pretty easy to find it, yeah. All right. Yeah, well, I actually already built it out a little bit, right? So let's go ahead and go back to the one that I initially built out because I already, you know, had the specs through. So this one over here, let me go ahead and continue my build. Okay, so we built it out. I also wanted to do the climate control, I think. Yeah, the 4-zone climate control. I think that's not added anymore. I have to re-add it, so hold on. You know what's interesting? I can't seem to find it anymore. Well, that's odd. Okay. That's okay. I can live without it. Oh no, it is. It is here. Price for equipment. Good, good. So yeah, let's go ahead and see if we can see if it's available. So we can request that vehicle. We'll go ahead and pop in our zip here. All right. And so here we go. We can try to request the vehicle. All right. Again, okay, well, at this point, you'd have to put in personal information, but it looks like it is indeed available. So there we are. Okay. So what's happening here is now we're going to be going on to the Audi page, all right? And same thing, right? What we're supposed to do, try to find a vehicle. All right, same price point. So again, let's go for the Q5, I think is electric, right? Let's look for the regular Q5. I think I've heard pretty good things there. Starting at $44,000, right? That's a fairly good price. Oh, it is an electrified. Okay, that's fine. So this is the gas-powered version, which still works great. I already know what the seating capacity is. That's fine. And all right, 0 to 60. It's definitely very technologically advanced. Okay. So this would be the one that I would get, right? I've already looked at this in real life, so I already know exactly what I would do. I wouldn't customize this just because it's good as is. And now let me go back here to the main Audi page, and then we're going to see if we can find an electric vehicle at that comparable price point. Okay, so here we go. We got the e-G-tron. Okay. Here we go. This is electrified, right? What does it start at? 104,000. Okay. Well, that wouldn't really fit our budget per se. So I don't know if you can actually find an EV underneath the Audi section, right? That can meet that. So let's go ahead and take a look. All EV models. Definitely want to be able to try to. Oh, here we go. Q4. Okay. And it's an SUV. So this is even cheaper, right? You could get two of these for one Porsche almost at the same price point. Good range. Good. You know what? I'd probably pick the EV at this point. We got better capacity, good seating. It's at half price. And there we go. I like the price of the Audi, but the Porsche is higher end. So hold on. Audi is easier to use, given the layout of the overall homepage. So I definitely think Audi is a little bit easier to use.